Hi everybody, I'm Sahara Mahmood from my Condo Source, and I'm here today with Jason Lam, Vice President of Sales and Marketing at CentreCourt, and we're here to talk about Prime Condos located at Jarvis and Dundas. Prime Condos is now launching in a neighborhood that CentreCourt is very familiar with.
Yes.
You have a lot of developments in that area already. You have 199 Church, you have Core Condos, Grid Condos, 250 Church coming later this year.
411 Church, a number of projects.
Essentially, you have been following the smart money in the downtown east side.
Yes.
Can you talk a little bit more about what that term means and
Absolutely.
How that can translate to our buyers?
So fundamentally speaking, when you're looking at real estate, it's about being able to look ahead. What it looks like today is not what it'll look like tomorrow. It's certainly not going to look like what it will look like 4 years from now.
Mm-hmm.
So having that ability to see into the future a little bit by using a little bit of logic and also looking at what history has told us. So following the smart money, step one, you're seeing premier developers such as CentreCourt investing in the East Core, which is east of Yonge Street, Church, Jarvis, Sherbourne, Parliament.
Mm-hmm.
And the who's who are developing, or have already developed sites in those locations.
Right.
So, you know, when you understand what that's like, you got to understand, you know, what the West Court represents. West of Yonge Street is Bay. West of Bay is University. When was the last time you saw launches on Bay and University? They don't come online because that land is so scarce. And if it did, you'd be $2,000 a foot, if not more, today. So equal distance to Yonge, which is the center of Toronto, you've got Church, you've got Jarvis, poised for redevelopment, lots of opportunity. But the value is there. It's not $2,000 a foot. So, you know, you as a logical person are going to say, well, if they can't build on Bay, they're going to build on Church and Jarvis and Sherbourne and Parliament. That's the only place that they can go if you want to be south of Bloor in the heart of the city. So when you see the number of these projects that are coming online, you know, they are changing the fabric of the Toronto East Core. You're seeing it with each passing day with contributions of Ryerson. And I think that's the beauty, is understanding that the East Core has a ton of potential. It's not where it needs to be yet. You're going to grow, and you're seeing it firsthand. So it's important that, you know, I use Regent Park as an example. I use Liberty Village as an example,
mm-hmm.
as well as you know, Square One. You look at VMC. The
right.
first building 5 years ago, 10 years ago, 15 years ago, it stood on its own. But the plan was there. And people such as myself are telling you, we're going to build 15 more buildings. You can either sit on the sidelines and say, wow, I can't believe that happened. I didn't know.
Yeah.
Or I'm so shocked. Or you could be someone that's a visionary that understands that, wow, they just told me that there's
right.
a lot of opportunity. That this is going to happen whether I like it or not.
Right.
So I might as well follow the smart money. I might as well apply this opportunity to my portfolio
mm-hmm.
so that I can gain from this. So that's what's happening in the East Core. That's what's happened time and time again. And that's why I think Prime is one of the most exciting opportunities in the downtown core, in the market as a whole, when it comes to pre-construction opportunities today.